In my first video on Hardy Cross method, I described the method. Then I made another video showing how to set up the calculations in Excel. Neither of these videos, though, really explained the context where you'd see the Hardy Cross method used, and this resulted in some of you having questions. Thanks for asking the questions. In this video, I hope to answer two questions. How do you analyze a pipeline that connects to your network from the existing system? And how do you analyze a pipeline that is a dead end extending beyond any one of the junctions in your system? Here we start with the same network used in my first Hardy Cross video. And to this network, I'll add the context of a small housing development with 55 residential dwelling units. This system receives its water from an existing pipeline we'll label P7. Also, this system has a small cul-de-sac with a dead-end pipeline that we'll label as P8. So just as in the first video showed, the result for the Hardy Cross method can help you find the size of each pipeline and the residual pressure at each junction. To proceed, we must subdivide the system into service areas. In this case, 6 service areas. The numbers in blue here are the number of houses in each service area. The number of homes helps us compute the water demand for each junction, which we'll label as Q and show it with an arrow leaving the junction. We are ready to begin the analysis with step 1, where we analyze the hydraulics of pipe 7, starting with identifying the flow rate in pipe 7, which is just the total flow rate of the system. Once you have the flow rate, then you can find the diameter of the pipeline using the maximum velocity criteria or the maximum head loss criteria or both. The result of both calculations gives you a decimal value, so you'll need to round up the final result to the next standard pipeline size. With the final diameter in hand, now you can compute the head loss in the pipeline, which then helps you compute the residual pressure at junction 1. When you do this analysis in practice, the agency operating the system typically provides you with the initial pressure, P0, where you connect to the system. So the pressure at junction 1 is simply the initial pressure at P0 minus the head loss in pipe 7. The next step is to run the Hardy Cross method on the entire network, which will give you the flow rate, diameter, and head loss at each pipeline. This gives you the residual pressure at each of the junctions. One thing to note is when you analyze the network using Hardy Cross, you need to add the flow rate for junction 6 to junction 4 to determine the residual pressure at junction 4. This accounts for the impact the dead-end pipeline has on the network analysis. As a final task in the Hardy Cross method, you compute the residual pressure at junction 4 by starting with the pressure at junction 1 and then subtracting the head loss in pipes 6 and 4. After the network analysis is complete, you now have the information to analyze pipe 8. The flow rate is simply the water demand for the homes in the service area. The diameter of the pipeline is found once again using the max velocity and max head loss methods, and then round them up to the next standard pipe diameter. And just as before, the head loss is found using the actual pipeline diameter. The final step is to compute the residual pressure at junction 6 by subtracting the head loss from pipe 8 and the residual pressure found at junction 4. And that is how you not only analyze the network using Hardy Cross, but add on the analysis of the connection to the existing system, as well as any dead-end pipelines connected to your network.